Hello and welcome to a new video and a new setup. I want to find a new setup that I can work with now in winter time, and because it's dark outside and the clock is 6:30 and it's dark, and I don't know if this is a good setup or not. I have to try a little bit different things, and I don't know about the lighting. It was a long time ago. I'm filmed with my studio lights, and yes, I have the curtain down because the studio light is reflecting in the window. And we live in a tiny apartment. I don't want to disturb my boyfriend when I'm filming because he lives here too, so I will try this and see how it goes, so I hope you like it. I think this looks a little bit more interesting because you can see a little bit of my makeup. Yeah, that was not what this video was going to be about. I am doing a tag video again. I think it's fun that the tag videos are on upgoing right now. There are more tag videos now than has been for a long time. A couple of years ago there were so many tag videos, and now not so much, but I think there are coming more and more tag videos. So the tag video I am doing today is by Nisipisa. I don't follow her, I haven't seen her video yet. I has seen Spooky Lips and Fat Hips, also known as Lacey, and Angelica, Nyqvist do this, so I will leave all of their channels down below, and I will leave the questions down below. And this tag is the makeup memories tag, so we will just start, and this is 8 questions. And the first question is, oldest makeup item in your collection? And I have to search for this. I looked at my old blog, and I have been decluttering my makeup collection a lot and throw away most of my old makeup. But the oldest makeup item I have, if this should count as a makeup item, it's this kabuki brush from e.l.f. I have had this for like 5 or 6 years, and I love this kabuki brush. I don't know if Face e.l.f. still sell this one, but this was my first kabuki brush and the only one I have think I need. I use this for my mineral foundation, my powder foundation, and I need to clean this because it's supposed to be black and now it's like gray, but I still love this brush and it has held up very good. I don't wash it so often because I don't use my mineral foundation that often anymore, but it's still very good shape. This is from e.l.f.'s a little bit more expensive side, so I think this was a little more expensive than their usual brushes. I think it was e.l.f. Professional, but this is a really good brush, so if they still have it and you need a kabuki brush, I can really recommend this. It's pretty big, so it covers, yeah, it's a really good brush. Question number 2 is the very first makeup item you ever purchased. And I don't really know. When I was like 6 or 7 maybe, I bought like these lip glosses. But that's not a makeup item. I think one of the first was a mascara from, I think it's Maybelline. It's a pink tube and a green cap. I think that everybody I knew had this mascara, and I think they relaunched it a couple of years ago. Now I don't use Maybelline, but I think that would have been the first makeup item I bought myself. I didn't use mascara so often, it was maybe like on school discos and stuff like that, nothing I used in school, but I think that was my first makeup item I ever bought, that mascara. I can leave a picture here if you don't know which one I talk about, but I believe that all that are in my age know exactly what mascara I'm talking about. It must have been one of the most popular mascaras ever. Okay, question number three. Your favorite of your makeup eras. And I'm gonna say the same thing as Lacey. And that's now. I like my makeup style now the most. Because now I try things that I want to try. And I do things I want to do. A couple of years ago, I think I never would have done this makeup look. And now I do it like it's a normal makeup look for me. So I love that. And I experiment. And I do whatever I want. So I think this is my favorite makeup era. My now makeup era. So question number four is the darkest of your makeup eras. And I think it was when I made a raccoon eyes in high school. I think I was 14 to 19. That didn't suit me. It was not... I liked it then. And that's good that I liked it then. But now when I think about it, it was not a good look for me. I could have done it better than I did. So I think that is my darkest. In both... darkest of colors and darkest of, yeah, the darkest of my makeup eras is when I had these raccoon eyes. Question number five. Best makeup related memory. And I think this is a little bit of a hard question, because I don't know if I have a makeup memory like that, but I think I said this in my makeup journey tag, and that is, it should have been when I bought my Naked 2 palette from Urban Decay, because I remember how happy I was. I was in London with my boyfriend. I finally could get my hands off Urban Decay. I don't think you could buy it in Sweden at that time. This was like 2013, I think we were in London. No. Yeah, I think so. And yeah, I was so happy about it. I loved it. I was so afraid that this was going to break in the suitcase on the flight home. And I was so happy when I bought it. It was, I couldn't stop looking at it. I couldn't stop using it. And I felt so good when I used it. I really loved the shadows. So that is my best makeup memory. So the next question is your worst makeup related memory. And I don't know if I have a worst, like in particular. Maybe it was sometime when I was in high school and I had my raccoon period. A lot of people in the school commented about it. And the way I look, because I didn't look like most of the people in my school. It was a pretty small school, and they commenting on it, and I wasn't in a good place in my life at that time, and I think it got to me, even though I don't know if I ever wanted to acknowledge that. I think it gotten to me at the time, and I think it made me feel worse. I still use the makeup as I did, but I think it hurt me, even though I don't know if it did then. I just start thinking about this now. I think it hurt me more than I would ever say to anybody. So maybe that is the worst makeup related memory. I don't have any. I haven't been through anything else I can remember that would make me sad when it comes to makeup, so... Okay, so question number five. Old flame product, something you use to hardcore covet. And... yeah, I know. I think it should be this one. This is a foundation from a Swedish brand. It's called Makeup Store, and this is a CC foundation in the color Fair. And this was the first foundation I found that suit my pale skin. So I love this. And it was discontinued and I was so sad about it. So I bought a backup when they were selling out. And now I can't use it anymore. I can use it, but it does not suit my skin anymore. And it's not because it's old, because I have had this in my drawer forever and then I open it and it didn't suit me anymore. The color was good, but the formula was not. I don't know if I'm drier now and I'm a little bit older now. It's not good on my skin. It doesn't feel as good as I remembered it for my skin, or that I've tried other foundations, but this was my baby. When my first tube went out, I was so sad. And now I'm throwing this away and I have used like half of it, so this was true love. But now it doesn't suit me anymore. The color is good, but the formula is not good for my skin. And the last question is, if you could go back in time and tell your younger self something about makeup, what would you say? Okay, I think we are going to get a little bit deep on this one. I come from a really small town and none of my friends have a big interest in makeup from that time. And I started to get an interest, but I had nobody to share it with. And I didn't have the courage to use the makeup I wanted to. So I would tell myself to just don't give a fuck what anybody say. Just do you, do what you want. And feel good about it. I would tell myself to just go out in that black lip. Don't mind anybody. Go out with the purple eyes. Just do it. Do what you want. Fill in your brows if you want to. Just do it. I want to tell my younger self that. Just do it. Don't care what others say. I try to live by it now. It goes pretty good. I go out like this. So, I want to tell my younger self, just don't give a fuck what anybody say. Just do you. And if you feel good about it, just do it. And I don't want to tell my younger self. And if you want to try something, just do it. That applies at so many different things in my life. Like my ears. I wanted to stretch them when I was like, how old? I've been 15, 16, and I did stretch them, but then one of them burst. Not the whole ear, but yeah. I went too fast, and it scared me of it, and I was too afraid to do it again, just because what people say and like that, and yeah. Now I have them. I'm happy with my ears, and the same with my septum piercing. I have wanted this for like 10 years before I took it, because I was afraid what people are going to say. So I want to tell my younger self, just do what you want. If you want it, do it. So that was everything for this tag video. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, please press like. And if you're not subscribing to my channel, do, so you don't miss any of my videos. And if you want to do this tag, do it and tell me in comments so I can watch your video. So I hope I see you in my next video. Bye!